Hello everyone and welcome to this video. Today I want to share with you some tips and tricks in Dynamo that I picked up over the years and that come in very handy when you work with Dynamo a lot. So today I want to share them with you so that you can learn how to work better and faster in Dynamo. So whether you're a beginner or you've worked with Dynamo for quite some time, I think you can take something from this video because not all of the things that I'm going to show are very well known. So let's jump right into it and see if there's something for you. Okay, so here we are in the Dynamo user interface, and the first thing I want to show you is how you can duplicate a node. So for example, here we want to create a point by x, y, and z coordinate, and I already have this number slider for the x coordinate, and now I want to have the same for y and z. So I could either copy and paste it, or I can select the number slider and then press the Ctrl key and just drag another duplicate down. So that's very easy, and this was already our first tip. And now if you've worked in big Dynamo scripts before, you might know how easy it is for things to get a bit messy, let's say. So keeping everything tidy and organized is very important. And a way to do this would be if I now want to sort up these number sliders, to select them and then right click and go to align selection. And now I have all these possibilities to line them up neatly. So we now choose right, and they jump into the right place. So the next thing I want to show you is over here. So here we got this all elements of a category node that has two paths going from his element output. But now let's say I don't want to select all elements anymore, but I just want to work with a few selected elements that I take directly from the model. So I want to reassign those two paths to this node, and a way to do this is to press shift and then select and the element output, and now you see I have on my cursor the two paths and I can realign them to this new node. Of course this also works when you got a single path, so press shift and then ding, there you go. And now for my last tip, let's go over here. Okay, now the last thing that I want to show you, I'm sure a lot of you know already, is when you double click your mouse, you end up with a code block. Now in this code block, you can put anything from a double to a variable to a string. But I'm sure what a lot of you did not know is that you can also put a whole function in a code block and then call this function somewhere else in the script. So here we have a function called makeSpiral that creates a spiral for us. It takes in the number of turns you want to go, the radius of your spiral, the height, and a base point. And now in this function we calculate all the points on this spiral, and then in the end we create a NURBS curve that goes over those points. And now in another code block somewhere else in the script, or in various points in the script, we can call this function again by its name and with the input variables that we need. And then we set those variables to numbers, to values, and then we can create a beautiful spiral. Now let's run this and let me find, oh yeah. Here we have the spiral that we just created. And now when we play with those number sliders, the spiral will change accordingly. So, those were the four Dynamo tips that I wanted to show you today. I hope you can take something from it and it was helpful to you. I learned most of those tricks from a session with John Pearson, who is not only a genius when it comes to Dynamo, but also the person behind the Twitter account 60 Seconds Revit. So you might know him, or if not, make sure to follow him on Twitter, because he posts all of the cool stuff he does in Dynamo. And we filmed a little video together, in which he shows me all of his cool projects that he's worked on or is currently working on, and they're always not only funny, but also push the boundaries of what you would think would be possible in Dynamo or Revit. So make sure to stay tuned for that. it's going to be uploaded next week. And now one last thing. I would really like to get to know my audience better. So essentially you who's watching this video right now, I would like to hear where you're from, what's your profession, are you an architect, an engineer, or still studying? So feel free to comment down below and tell me your story. I would be very interested to hear all about it. So thank you very much for doing so, and then see you next Monday with another video. Bye bye.